Angela is here from Weight Watchers with a recipe for pumpkin swirl cheesecake. Angela, some advice for Thanksgiving,
some
biggest
advice,
day of the year.
My biggest advice for you, Dave, portion control. But if you want to use a bigger plate than this for your dessert,
yes.
I've got just the recipe for you.
Okay.
It's in our Weight Watchers magazine. It
Sounds
is, like
great.
You said, pumpkin swirl. And I think you're going to help me out because it's two different things going. I've got pumpkin puree here just out of the can. Okay. I'm going to add in some sugar. And I'm going to add in some pumpkin pie spice.
Okay.
And some salt. And I'm just going to whisk that around and get it all mixed in.
And so then, you've got that part. And
yes, you
question.
Are getting my cream cheese. I've got a little bit of regular cream cheese, 3 ounces, but I've got 5 ounces of light cream cheese, which is also called Neufchâtel.
Yes.
And that will help. So then I'm going to add into my filling, I'm going to add an egg one at a time and gently get that in. Thank you for helping me
yeah.
so we can get this
oh,
done.
Oh, absolutely. Now, question for you. Was I supposed to add in the wet ingredients first? It seemed like...
You know,
oh,
I'm going to let you do it however you
okay.
want because it's going to taste great no matter what.
Because they were getting caught up, see, in the beaters and all the cream cheese was getting caught up in it. But now
you know what?
It's let
you
loose.
Probably did it better even. So
oh,
anyways, I've
you.
Got this all stirred together. Then I'm going to put in 3/4 cup of fat-free half and half.
Okay.
All right. And keep whisking that around. I'm almost finished with my filling.
And I'm getting there in my cream cheese. I would probably recommend go ahead and just put the ingredients all in there, the cream cheese
just
and vanilla.
Just dump it all in.
And egg
That's
and
Dave's
sugar and
tip.
Then.
Dave's tip of the recipe, just dump it in. So
well,
I'm getting
yes.
this all stirred in. I know we're pressed for time, so we
oh,
want to show
good.
How it looks because when you swirl it, that's when it looks so pretty. All right, I'm ready.
Okay, I've done variable speed here, so many different speeds.
Yes,
I think we're good.
I have taken a 9-inch spring form pan, and I'm going to dump in my creation here. Let me get a little bit more of that out of there.
Yes.
And then after I get that in, then we're going to dump yours in on top of it
okay.
and swirl it around. And oh my goodness, I have to tell you, not that I should admit this, but I did lick the bowl at home and it was really good.
Okay,
so I
might have to
okay,
have you help me here. I am tempted to lick.
It's good. It's cream cheese and sugar.
Yeah.
What's not to want to lick?
Okay. Oh yeah, this is really good. And then the Neufchâtel, you know, it's not going to make a huge difference taste-wise, but the fat content, it sure
Correct.
Is.
And it's only a third less, so like
yeah.
you said, it's not going to make a huge difference.
I don't think so.
Once
no.
we get that all in our pan, which, by the way, I lined with parchment paper, and then I sprayed, then this is where it gets so pretty because we just start swirling that cream cheese in there, and once we really kind of get it up around, then look at that. It starts to...
Oh, looks
So it's really
wonderful.
Pretty. This is a crustless cheesecake, so that will help you a lot if you're trying to enjoy the... You know, we want to enjoy the things that we love at Thanksgiving, not feel like we missed out. So.
And then the time and temperature on this, Angela?
350. You're going to do it for about 1 hour and 5 minutes until
okay.
when you kind of give it a little jiggle. A little bit jiggly, but the edges are set. And then you're going to want to keep it in your fridge at least 3 hours and maybe even overnight if you have time.
Okay.
But there you go. It's all swirled.
Thank you so much. This looks wonderful. News on 6.com/recipe.